Randy, how's it going? This is Ryan Robles. How are you? Listen, I was working on a letter. It's supposed to be addressed to the National Guard Inspector General, and I was just thinking about old. Basically, memories going back to my childhood, and I remembered my brother suffered a lot, and he wouldn't talk about it, and then I was trying to figure out how much weight that had on my situation. I guess one of the reasons why my cousins and my sister decided not to help me spin a take. In other words, successfully being bribed by the F.B.I. or John Langley. And I just cannot believe that they're bona fide. In other words, my brother was a stooge. He was a mess up. Hid in his room, locked his door, had people break into his, he cried by himself on purpose, wouldn't talk about his issues, bad, left the doors open, we're talking about the doors into the apartment. And we'll just make the connection with sixth grade, seventh grade. Just intentionally trying to ruin, suicidal, asinine, not sure why he was doing this, then tried to blame me for it, and then, of course, getting even now by, stooping real low with testimony, and basically, your cousin, what my cousins are working on is basically defamation and stuff. I was trying to figure out what people were trying to spend ammunition for, very much the present, obviously. And the letter led to some pretty uncomfortable memories that I have to live with for the rest of my life. It's not a good situation. And I don't even remember trying to get a hold of you online or via YouTube. I think you slipped past my you were on my list, but I just unfortunately didn't get the chance to put you on, and that was before I scored the notebook. I've got a laptop now. I can update the YouTube subscriber that I'm using. I'm communicating with Erica and her double, evidently, and hopefully you. It won't be that hard for you to get a hold of. You just type in both of our names together, or your name, and you should get. And he should get, It's such a mysterious type of disinformation, you know, as far as what it's almost like my brother tried to egg on a hustler campaign from the time he was in fourth grade. I think it was revenge. I think that he plotted revenge a lot of the. And my brother would invite homeless up to the apartment. They would sneak in, break in, give him drugs. We had friends that would sneak in, break in, or tell other people to break in, sneak in. It's pretty messed up. I can't believe that my sister is trying to use any of this or any additional I mean, I didn't go to school with my sister. I don't understand what type of testimony to be defamation in uniform or with this type of facade. In other words, the clueless. In other words, a clueless facade in the National Guard. I mean, that doesn't make sense. And it smells like she's just trying to keep her kickbacks, is what it sounds like. Her kickbacks don't really equate to testifying against Securitas or testifying for or with her brother or that type of thing with her testimony. In other words, trying to charge me. She's trying to charge me for. Vegas, trying to hit me with a Vegas facade. I think it's pretty lame and disgusting, given that she's in the service and her cousins are in the service. You gotta hit me with Vegas in this situation, and in these circumstances, that's disgusting. I can't believe it. Think about it. Call my dad. Talk to my dad. He'll tell you. Yeah, they're all in the National Guard, or they're with the state, or they're in a frat and goofing off, and they're defamation like hell, and possibly assault. I don't quite remember Emily or Sally, but they are more than like. I'm trying to figure out. Anyways, Randy, listen. I hope you're all that. It's probably your retirement age. I would imagine. I hope you continue to collect the SSI and. That you managed to stay, you managed to survive. Hopefully you never ever become homeless ever again. It's my hope. Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate your time.